everybody, and welcome back again to Let's Play Assassin's Creed Origins. We have arrived in Cyrene, and we have already fought a few battles in the arena. As a matter of fact, I have continued to fight a few more battles off-camera the next three events until I unlocked the next boss battle. So that's a level 2 boss in the arena, basically. I don't know. Let me know if you would like to see these boss battles on camera. In that case, I will maybe do all the like pre-fights that you need to do to unlock the boss off camera, and then the actual boss battles on camera. I don't know. Let me know what you think. Yeah, but today I think I will actually continue with some side missions, and I suppose we may as well continue with the one that we picked up in the previous episode. Are you not entertained? Bayek is on the trail of an escaped gladiator and the prize sword he stole, but as he investigates, something about the story seems more than a little fishy. Okay, I guess I will have a look at that and see why this is fishy. Then again, I find it rather unlikely that Bayek would actually help capture an escaped gladiator. I feel he would be more interested in, like, helping gladiators escape. So, let's see what we need to do here. I mean, apparently something is fishy about this mission, so let's find out what it is. All right, where is the person I'm supposed to talk to? Are you the Lannister?
I saw the graffiti. Looks like you have a problem.
You could say that. My champion, the Thracian bear, escaped. He's a trained killer, mad as a hyena on heat. There's a bounty on him. Good money if you survive.
Why do they call him the bear?
Not so fast, Egyptian. I will only hire you if you show me you are capable of ripping the bear apart. Let us see how you fare against some of my best fighters. Live, and we will talk.
Okay, Onimestor, I'm sure that can be arranged.
Son of a bitch. Fought in arenas all across the Republic. He won me a fortune. In return, I treated him like a king. The best food, the best horse.
Perhaps he valued freedom more.
Right.
I earned my freedom through sweat and blood in the arena, not fleeing like a coward. Look, I don't care if that pox-ridden Canus lives or dies, but he stole my sword. Caesar gave me that in my final fight, and I want it back.
Oh, really?
Julius Caesar.
You know another Caesar? All right, lads. Come show this Egyptian.
Not yet.
Some Roman courtesies.
There's going to be a lot of Caesars to follow, because it essentially turns into a title rather than a name. Okay, so I gotta fight someone to prove that I can fight this gladiator. Okay, whatever you say. Anyway, can I, like, run maybe, or am I locked into... No, I'm locked into walking alongside him, apparently. Okay. Anyway, gives us more time to admire scenery, I suppose. I mean, this is quite obviously another Greek city, although at this point it's already part of the Roman Empire, or technically the Roman Republic. Empire doesn't exist yet. So, where exactly do we need to go? This seems rather far. Especially if you're not allowed to run. I mean, I can kind of run, but only until I catch up with him, and then I'm forced to walk. Apparently, he really, really wants to take his time.
Oi, it is Maison of Afrosinis.
Okay, upon we finally arrived at our destination. That took a lot longer than it had to. Okay, and now I'm just supposed to kill these random fighters. They don't even look all that threatening, to be honest.
Soil is dry. Let's water it with Egyptian blood.
I mean, especially after fighting significantly more dangerous foes in the arena.
Osiris awaits, brother.
We'll see about that. There we go. So, was that impressive enough?
Now that was a show. You are a warrior.
Have I proven myself?
Yeah, all right, don't get cocky. Rumor has reached me a farm east of Cyrene was attacked. Start there. That Thracian dog shagger won't come quietly. But the reward's for the weapon. You understand?
Okay.
I will find your champion. And your trophy.
Such confidence. I like it. I might even shed a tear if he got you.
Well, I feel flattered. Reach the farm massacre. Okay. Let's see. Okay. It's over here, the Sylphian farm. I don't have, like, a good fast travel spot in the area, so I guess I will just head over there on foot. And I'll bring you back once I've arrived. I mean, so far, this doesn't feel that fishy. Other than the fact that we're hunting an escaped gladiator, but maybe if he's a criminal and he's going around killing people, it's better to actually kill him. But I guess we will find out. I'll head over to my destination and we will see what's so fishy about it.
Whoa.
All right, I am approaching my destination, and I had to take a bit of a detour because apparently, except for the main road, all of this area is restricted for some reason, so you can't even take like the smaller roads. They're also in restricted territory. Anyway, I guess I will dismount and investigate the area on foot, and it looks like the farm is also restricted. And there's lions. What? Why? Yeah, there's definitely lions around here, and I feel they should not be here. Okay, let's kill the lions before they kill this poor guy. Alright. Take down this one first. Where's the other lion? Huh. Apparently it escaped. Well, that's probably for the better. At least this lion has some survival instinct. Okay, now let's look around. What can we find here? Well, dead people for once. Of course, the question is, did our escaped gladiator kill them or the lions? I mean, from the looks of it, this could have been a lion attack. Let's see.
Stab wounds, and from many swords. Unless the lions came armed, they did not kill these people.
Okay, so it's not the lions. Someone murdered them. I see. And I mean, something burnt as well. Pretty sure the lions didn't bring torches either.
Speared, then tortured. For what? Information?
Yeah, someone has been doing quite the massacre over here. Anyway, there's like another clue over here.
They shot him in the back. Was he trying to escape or hide? Swords, spears, arrows. This was not one man. It was a massacre.
All right, I guess this is fishy. If we're only hunting one escaped gladiator, but this was like the handiwork of at least several people. Now. Okay, while I'm here, I may as well pick up the loot, I suppose. Oh, it's a predator bow, but probably not one that I want to use. Yeah, there's like an opening over here. So I will probably have to destroy this.
There's something beneath this. A hidden cellar.
Okay, there we go. Let's go down. Can you please climb down here, Bayek? Okay, there we go. Okay. Seems to be some cellar for wine or olive oil. What do we got here? My friends and saviors, I can no longer stay here in good conscience. I fear helping me will bring you great misfortune. The Lannister will not let me go, and I could not live with myself if any more lives were lost because of me. I want nothing more than to start a new life, maybe earn an honest living.
Is that the escaped gladiator?
Fishing by day and with a good woman on my knee when I come home. Your grateful friend, Polymester. Okay, so the gladiator was here. He was trying to hide from the Lannister and his soldiers or bounty hunters. And they probably killed the people because they sheltered the escaped gladiator. Okay. I see what happened here.
Polymestor did not kill these people. They helped him. Maybe he reached the fishing village.
Maybe. But it seems that we have some people on the outside. At least I heard someone talking about the gladiator, so let's be careful here. Maybe more people have arrived trying to find him. I can't see anyone though. Not anyone who's hostile though. There are soldiers over here, but they're not really my concern at the moment. Okay, well in that case, I guess I have to find that fishing village. It's over here. Unsurprisingly, it's at the coast. So I will head over there and we will see if we can find the gladiator. Also, what is this? Can I read this? Silphium warning. The people of Rome own the Silphium. Thieves will be executed. Oh, I guess that's the reason all of this area is restricted, because the stuff on the fields, the silphium, is valuable and Rome claims it for themselves. The thing is, I have no idea what silphium is. I guess it's that yellow flower, but what makes it so valuable? I have no idea, but I will stay away from the fields and that's a snake, right? Alright, let's kill the snake. And I will look up what silphium is once I'm done with this recording. Oh, we have another rogue animal over here. Honey, there's a lot of snakes hiding in these fields. But yeah, I gotta look up what silphium is, because I have never heard that word before. Oh, donkey, sorry, another donkey. Donkeys are just like completely self-sufficient. They always walk around with any kind of master or overseer. Okay, we have our little village somewhere over here. And I can see, yeah, I can see some soldiers up on the cliffs, but not sure if they are my target. No, my target's down here at the beach. Alright. Let's see if we can find Polymestor. Is this a way I can climb down? Kinda. Don't want to glitch into some spot where I can't get out again. What are you guys doing here? Just sitting around? Oh, you gotta be the guy I'm looking for. I mean, he's tall enough to be a gladiator, I suppose. Let's talk.
I'm looking for a gladiator. The Thracian bear.
Another of the Lannister's cronies. How much did he pay you to slit
no,
my throat?
No, no, I'm not
he
here
only
to
wants
kill
his
you.
Sword.
Yes, covered in my guts. How did you find me? The farmers?
I'm sorry, Polymaster. Your friends are dead.
This is the Lannister's doing! I gave him my life, and now I will take his! I threw the sword in the sea. Take it! It has brought me nothing but bad luck.
Okay, well, I guess I can just retrieve the sword from the ocean. Of course, I honestly don't feel like returning the sword to the Lannister because he's obviously a big jerk if he ordered, you know, people to kill the villagers for sheltering the gladiator. But okay, let's search for the sword anyway, and then we can decide what to do about it. Can I buy some fish? I mean, this looks delicious, I guess. You can make some sushi with that. Again, I just like the visual storytelling in this game. I like the fact that there's actually a guy who is preparing the fish in a fishing village. This is just such a great attention to detail. Okay, let's look for that sword. Where can we find it? Oh, yep, I think I can see it.
The Lannister sword. I should talk to Polymaster.
Okay, let's do it. I mean, apparently doesn't want it back. And I don't want to give it to the Lannister. So, let's see what we can do with that. Whoa, I caused a huge wave by jumping into the water. Oh, what's going on here?
Where's my sword?
Oh, it's the Lannister and more soldiers.
Ah, here's the Egyptian clown! I knew he would...
Can I just kill you? Well, I could have assassinated him, but I was a little bit too slow. Alright, I will fight by your side because... The Lannister is clearly the bigger jerk here. There we go. Oh, he's still alive. Of all the people, he managed to survive the longest. Interesting. There we go. So, I think you should be free now. Let me loot these people. Now I will talk to you.
That was a battle to make Sharon weep! Thank you!
Bayek.
Bayek. That bastard had no code. I earned my life back 1,000-fold, but I made too much coin for him.
Mm-hmm.
In the arena and the rich Roman beds. Keep Caesar's sword. It belongs to one who stands for freedom and honor.
Thanks. I will stain it with the proper blood. The deserving blood. What will you do?
Fish, mend my nets, and find a good, plump woman to settle down with. I will make the most of this new life.
Sounds good to me. I wish you all the best. And I'm glad we could end this quest like this, because... hunting down an escaped gladiator just didn't feel right. It didn't feel like something Bayek would do, unless he was actually like dangerous and killing people. Okay, but then, you know, It wasn't because he was an escaped gladiator, but because he was a criminal. All right, so we have finished this task, but we have quite a few back in Cyrene. So I guess I'm just going to fast travel back into the city and we will pick another one. Maybe just the one that's closest to my fast travel spot here. We have a bit of time left in this episode, so let's see if we can finish this today. Also, I wanna have a look at the sword that he gave me and if I have any kind of use for it. Sword of the Free, a rare regular sword. Nah, it's not a legendary one. Legendary ones are quite hard to find. And I have far too much crap that I need to sell at some point, but I can do this off camera. Right, where is that quest that I just put a marker on? Okay, it's over here.
High position, Gere.
Let's see what we have to do for this one. Also, I would like to check out some of the buildings here and do like a proper sightseeing tour.
The rarest and most exotic goods in Cyrene. Talk to the mouse.
The mouse.
Hey, you there! Big strong Egyptian!
That Futos Mintos. He's tainting our market with his worthless tat.
Okay. I don't know. It looks good to me. We got some lapis lazuli over here. And various amulets and pieces of jewelry. All very Egyptian. I mean, they're clearly made by or for Egyptians. So, let's talk to the guy.
Get many Egyptians in Cyrene.
You'll get no judgment from the mouse, but you did stick out.
The mouse? And not title, my friend.
Yes, yes, I am the mouse, because I can access the more hard-to-find trinkets. If you follow me to my shop, I'll show you. Bows, blades, scepters, you won't be disappointed. The mouse guarantees it. Sir...
Bayek. All right. Let's see what you have, mouse. Don't
the
you
mouse
have trouble
trip.
With the Romans?
Well, you know what they say about our Latin friends? The Greeks invented the threesome, and the Romans added women.
Oh, boy.
Besides, I know how to stay hidden, Sir Bayek. With the way I look, I have to.
That's him! The mouse!
Oh, I didn't intend to cut you off. I'm sorry. I had no idea that this would end in a attack. But I will defend you against these soldiers. Oh, there's another one. I didn't see you at all, my friend. Okay. Mr. Mouse, I think you made some enemies.
Oh, cursed mouse. Woeful mouse. They took it. They took everything, Sir Bayek.
Oh, they took your fine goods.
The Roman swine must have taken my chest to the barracks. Please, will you recover it?
And why would I do that?
Because you know what it's like to be brushed aside, victimized by those who hold themselves above you. The mouse will die on the streets with no living to support him. And what of the children? Will no one think of the children? And I could probably spare a fine reward for my savior.
Well,
I would not want the children on my conscience.
God bless you, Sir Bayek. I will wait for you in the market behind the paths. Good luck, my friend.
Yeah, if you want Bayek's help, you just have to appeal to his sense of justice, and then he just can't refuse. He just has to help everyone, right? But okay, let's do it. Apparently, I have to go over here. It's not too far away, so let's see if we can find your chest for you. The barracks are near the north entrance of Cyrene. The mouse keeps his stash in a chest. It means that I probably have to infiltrate the barracks. But I mean, I just have to find the chest, and I probably don't have to, like, completely finish this place, as in kill every single person. Also, what is this large building over here? We also have a nice temple on top of the hill. So yeah, I definitely need to do a little bit of sightseeing at some point. But for now, let's just try to finish this quest. And I guess I will try to get the chest without actually cleaning out the entire place. It kind of depends on where it is exactly, I suppose. I mean, it might actually be somewhere below me. Weird. Okay, let's see. What would be the best way to get inside here? I mean, I could probably climb onto the barracks, or maybe this watchtower over here. That would give me a nice high vantage point to kill a few soldiers and then try to find that chest. Let's do it. I mean, it looks like there is someone on the battlements of this gate, but if it's just one person, he won't stand a chance against me.
Right.
Let's take him down first. Oh, there's some people in sight here. Alright, but I think I can just ignore those. Okay. There is a second fire.
This area is off limits.
But it is pretty far away, so the question is if I actually want to bother disabling it. Let's start by killing this guy over here. Alright. Alright, let's maybe stay on this side of the wall. We also have like civilians in the camp, but again, that's probably not what I want to do at the moment. Yeah, the chest is somewhere below the ground. That makes this endeavor somewhat more complicated because I need to find the way down. I mean, maybe I have to go inside the building and then we can find our way downstairs. Okay. Well, there's definitely some stuff in here, but not the chest I'm looking for. Let's go down here. Oh, hang on a second. Is the captain slash commander coming inside here? Oh, he is. Well, maybe this actually gives me an opportunity to kill him. Oh, he's coming up here even. Alright. Well, I'm waiting for you. Alright, let's do it. That was a nice, clean, stealthy kill. Okay, it was the commander. Now, let's go back down again. Oh, someone did see me, at least a little bit. Yeah, there's someone standing on the outside. And yeah, the stupid treasure is definitely below me. And I can't... Oh, here we go. Here we go. Okay. I found it. I found it.
The mouse's stash.
Oh, I have to carry it. Ugh. Don't like that at all. Well, okay. Before I start carrying it, I will make sure I have looted the rest of this place. And there's like something I can interact with over here. Oh, mummies?
They are preparing the bodies for cremation. I wonder what soil these soldiers died upon. Cyrenaica or Egypt?
Hmm. I don't know. Why does it matter? Treating the soldiers. We used forceps to try and remove the arrowheads, but Julius Onaeus had lost too much blood and died before we could remove them. When treating a curable wound, there are two things to remember. Preventing hemorrhage and avoiding inflammation. Vinegar can staunch the flow of blood, but inflammation is more likely with bone, sinew, cartilage, or muscle is injured. Bandages should be of white linen to cover in a single turn not only the wound, but a little on the edges on both sides. That doesn't sound unreasonable, to be honest. Anyway, I gotta take the box now and get it out of here. Alright, there's another staircase over here. I'm not sure if this is going to be a better way. I honestly don't think so. I feel the way I came from was a good way because I could escape via the roofs. Alright, let's make sure no soldier has appeared in here. Of course, the question is, can I, like, climb while I'm carrying this? Yeah, this might be a problem. Probably can't climb up here, huh? Nope, I can't. I can't. Okay. Well, I have to find an alternative route out of here, I suppose. Let's see. There's the main gate. Do we have any other potential exits? There's a gate over here. But it's not really any closer. So I may have to get out via the main gate. Or can we, like, go through the building? No, it doesn't look like there's any kind of door on this side, so this is probably not going to work. Alright, well, this is going to be very exciting. I mean, there are definitely guards in front of the main gate, but once I'm past the guard, I can just try to run. I mean, I'm not sure how fast I can run with the box I'm carrying. Uh-oh. Okay, they didn't see me. Yeah, I think I will just try to escape via the main gate. Alright, well, that actually worked better than I expected. They didn't really care for me leaving the place. Okay, in that case, let's go back to the mouse and give him his precious chest. I guess you're up here. Alright, look what I found. Let's put it down here.
Ah, Bayek, did you find my chest? You have saved my life for a second time, Sir Bayek. I am blessed. Blessed by the gods who brought you to me on this, the greatest of days. The mouse will embrace you as a sign of my undying gratitude.
Okay.
Please don't.
Then money. I will shower you with riches to make Crisis jealous.
Take care of yourself, Mouse. Try not to get caught in any more traps, huh?
Ah, such grace, such wit. You deserve more than mere money. Come see me again later. I will find you something special from my stash.
Okay. So why can't you just give it to me now? Why should I come back later?
Sir Bayek, my eyes weep in joy at the sight of you. Did you hear? Some black market merchant is trying to undercut me.
Okay. So, are you saying that you have like another task for me? I thought you were going to give me a reward. Well, apparently at the moment he doesn't have anything for me. Not a new quest and not any kind of reward. Huh. Look at this kitchen. I thought it was a kitchen sink, but I guess it's like the stove. You can light a fire underneath it. There's probably not a kitchen sink here. They're probably just going to like a well or whatever. Okay, well, we have finished another quest. There's obviously a number of quests in the area. There's also one down here. But since the episode is already kind of long, I don't think I'm going to start a new quest. But I do want to do some sightseeing. So maybe we're going to start with some of these unusual buildings. I would like to see what they're all about. For example, the one over here. I mean, this looks unusual. What exactly is this? I mean, it doesn't seem to be restricted. So hopefully I can... properly explore it. Does it have a door? Alright, this is the door, but it doesn't seem to be open. Okay, well, it doesn't really tell me what kind of building this is. And you can't really see what's going on inside. Although, it does have like a mosaic on the floor. Huh. Come on, there has to be a way to get inside here. Why would they bother to render the inside of this building if you can't go inside? I mean, I may have to go into this building for some quest at some point. Because at the moment I can't find any actual way to enter this place. Okay, well, I guess I will come back later and see if I can find a way inside, but I'm going to assume it has to be part of a quest. Also, it seems like there's a treasure inside, so there's gotta be a way inside here, right? Yeah, but let's maybe come back later, because I'm going to assume that I have to wait for an actual quest to open this. Instead, I would like to have a look at that temple on top of the hill. Okay, we have a papyrus somewhere around here. Guess it doesn't hurt to pick it up already. Seems to be inside the temple. Oh, it's the Temple of Zeus. Alright, that makes sense. Since we're in an entirely Greek city now, we have proper Greek gods and not these Egyptian-Greek hybrids like Serapis, but actual Greek gods. He does look like the statue in the library, so he does have the ram's horns of Zeus Ammon, So I guess there is still some Egyptian elements to the statue. I guess I just didn't want to make another statue of Zeus without the horns. Because the horns are a very typical Egyptian feature that they took over from Amun. Anyway, let's have a look at our papyrus. North of Apollonia, I'm next to a lifesaver. It guides in darkness and fog, and I sit beside it under something that did not heed its warning. Yeah, that's gotta be the lighthouse we've seen earlier, right? I mean, I can kinda make out that riddle even without actually seeing the place. I'm not sure if Apollonia is on my map. I think it was like one of these coastal villages. Probably this one over here, and I'm going to assume that this might be the lighthouse. It's kind of hard to tell because it's on the edge of the discovered territory. All right, yeah, got a temple of Zeus in here. That's neat. Do we got something else? Yeah, that's gotta be the place, right? The lighthouse. Sure, let's head over there. May as well pick up that treasure while we're here. Oh no, this is going a lot... I didn't expect this to be so deep. Most unnecessary death ever. Alright. And for some reason, it's night again. Why? It was a night before. Okay, but let's be more careful now. As a matter of fact, I'm not entirely sure if I can just drop down here. Let's take a safer approach like this one over here. At least I'm pretty sure that there's stuff I can hold on to. Alright. Now, let's head over to the lighthouse and find that treasure. All right, this place is Apollonia, which means the lighthouse has gotta be the place of the treasure. And I do believe there's another side mission somewhere around here. But we will have a look at that in the next episode. Oh, we have barracks over here. Yeah, I gotta go around the barracks if I want to reach the lighthouse. Let's do it.
Go! Yeah!
Manian van Paraxen.
A long one through.
And since the treasure is supposed to be near something that didn't heed the lighthouse's warning, I'm going to assume that there's a shipwreck somewhere in the vicinity. Let's see. Where could it be? I mean, there's a very tiny wreckage over here. And apparently, that's it. There we go. And I got another shield. Probably not a shield I would like to use, but I kind of want to solve all these puzzles at some point. Okay, yeah, I think we have explored enough for today. I will climb up to the top of the lighthouse to synchronize the viewpoint. And I think then it's time to end the episode. Oh, hang on a second. The synchronizing point is actually over here. Let's do it. Okay, and I think this is a nice view to finish off this episode. The ocean at the Mediterranean coast, and all the way in the distance, the lighthouse of Pharos. Okay, yeah, I guess that's enough for today, and I suppose we will just continue doing more side missions in the next episode, because there's many more in this area. So as usual, thank you for watching, and see you again next time.